Okay, we are live. Good morning or afternoon or evening, depending on where you are. My name is Julie Wima, and I'm the Executive Director of Opera Programs Berlin and the Dramatic Voices Program. Thank you so much for joining us for this masterclass. It is my great pleasure to introduce our clinician for today's class. Caroline Dowdle is staff pianist for the Britten Peers School in Aldeburgh. She has given recitals in the UK, France, Austria, Russia, Switzerland, and Germany, to name a few, with some of the most prominent singers and instrumentalists of our generation. Since 2008, she has run the Opera Academy at the Verbier International Music Festival, is a coach for the Jet Parker Young Artist Program at the Royal Opera House Covent Garden, is a professor to the faculty of the Royal College of Music since 2015, and is the musical director of the Zamling Academy for Young Singers. She has also given countless masterclasses around the world and worked with thousands of singers on an extremely wide range of vocal repertoire, both in opera and song, and possesses some of the keenest ears in the business. Caroline, thank you so much for being with us. It's our honor to have you, and we're looking forward to our second installment of Masterclass with you.
Thanks, Julie. Great. I look forward to it.
All right, our first singer today will be Melissa. Melissa, if you could unmute yourself, let us know where you're calling from and what you will be singing today.
Messiaen's Poems for Me for dramatic soprano with collaborative artist Lynn Mackey.
I go see.
Thanks, Melissa. Beautiful. And how lovely you got your pianist with you. Fantastic. I'm so glad. It's so much easier than your backing tracks that everyone's been very brave with. Great. Beautiful song. What do you know about it? What's the story here?
So, the Poems for Me, this is a song cycle for orchestra and dramatic soprano that Messiaen wrote for his wife. Her nickname was Me.
Mm-hmm.
And in this particular piece, Le Collier, he is describing his wife's, his lover's arms around his neck early in the morning that embraced him like a necklace.
Beautiful. Okay, absolutely. So a couple of things. I have a couple of questions. What is the first, you know how you get sometimes in the first thing in the morning, you get an idea, a realization. And that realization can be how you think of, how he's thinking of his wife, for example. So if you were to say the words, this is a slightly hippie exercise, I'm warning you now. If you were to say the words, I've just realized, okay, that means I've just had this thought, like the light bulb moment. Could you choose where to say that? If you were to speak the poem for me, could you say where you feel it's appropriate, I've just realized? For example, I would go, I've just realized, printemps enchaîné, you are like the embodiment of spring, all bundled up, yeah. So would you mind doing that quickly for me? So what I need you to say is out loud, I've just realized. That means every time you have a new image which your wife is reminding you of, can you do that for me? Yes.
Look when you first wake up.
Beautiful. And in fact, what I'm going to do is make it even simpler for you. All I need, because I know you understand so well what it means. Just, I'll give you an example. For example, as it's playing in the beginning, I would say, I've just realized, printemps enchaîné. I've just realized, not that, arc-en-ciel léger du matin. So you keep on improving the description. It's whether you think it's a list or an improvement of the description. What do you feel?
I think he realizes the colors, especially because the poem talks about whimsical pearls and multicolored.
Mm-hmm.
I think he realizes how the sunlight dances on her face. And he realizes the shadows.
Sure. So if he was jotting down on a piece of paper with his pen the poem, which is must have been what he did. Do you think he's jotting down a list he's pre-arranged, or whether it's occurring to him as he goes?
I think that it's occurring to him as he goes.
I love that, because it's more useful for us, okay? It's as performers, it's more useful to have the ideas immediately rather than carry them in a small rucksack. You see what I mean? So I think what I want to understand now, can this be the idea coming to you, the click with the finger? And can you speak the poem for me in French, clicking your finger as the ideas come? So we'll see where the different thought events are.
Sure, sure.
Is that okay? Just speaking is great. Good. And here, let's not do it in the rhythm of the piece. Let's do it quite lively, like you were. In fact, let's do it in the verse of the poem. Printemps enchaîné, arc-en-ciel léger du matin. So there is a sense of fall of the language as well, which we'll use when we sing it as well. So just speaking like an actor, but with clicking on each thought event.
Ah, mon collier, mon collier.
Good. Why do you repeat it?
For emphasis.
Yeah, that's always going to be true. But let's say we can do something slightly more interesting than that. We can say, for example, someone in the audience hasn't understood. It feels right, you said it, so you're going to say it again because it feels so right. There's always a reason that we repeat something. Yes, we're emphasizing, but that's just the generalization of it. If you can find something specific.
I think the first one is the actual, recognizing what's happening, and the second one is taking the time to realize how beautiful it is.
I love it. So those are two slightly different energies then, if that's fair. Can you go from the first one? Ah, mon collier.
Ah, mon collier. Ah. Mon collier.
Great. On you go.
Petit soutien vivant.
I need to know that that's a new thought that you're developing, okay? So, petit soutien vivant. And this is something that puzzles me about the poem. Why does he talk about his ears?
Against the bed sheet, or he can hear her sigh as she moves. I think
lovely. And those ears are used to hearing a lot. I guess as a composer, his ears hear a lot of things.
Right.
And his ears hear a lot of things that bore him, and presumably this is something precious for him to have. Great. Because right. We would say usually tired eyes, wouldn't we? We would have more tired eyes than ears, but he's a composer.
And his use of tritones, tertian chords, those types of things, he really used to sort of represent the Trinity, because he believed that this physical act that he's engaging in with his wife is actually sort of an act of transcendence, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's not just the physical act, it's the spiritual and emotional act that occurs in connecting physically.
Fantastic. I love it.
Yeah.
Great. So keep going. Collier de renouveau. So, and if you can, even as you speak it, be careful not to find the beats in the music, because that's not useful, especially in French. Collier de renouveau. Renouveau. Keep it smooth. De sourire et de grâce. Those are really different things. Take your time to think of the different things.
Mm-hmm.
Good. Perle dure et cocasse. So hard pause, and then cocasse. Actually, I looked it up. It's not just whimsical, it's funny.
Mm-hmm.
Like a funny person. That's nice to know. That's an essence of his wife. Very nice. And also, pearls, I don't know. These guys knew a lot of the symbolism. Pearls represent wisdom, purity, fidelity, all these other things. So I suspect it's not by chance he's called her a string of pearls.
Okay.
It doesn't, I mean, it's just nice to know. It doesn't really matter, but it's nice to know. On you go. So why courbe? Why courbe? Paysage courbe?
Well, I think the curving landscape is her body.
Is it her? So as he looks at her lying down. Great. Okay. Super.
The curves and the ebbs and flows.
Nice.
She is in that moment.
Super. Keep going.
Épousant les frères du matin.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Tes deux bras autour de mon cou ce matin. Keep, make sure you get the verse pattern as well. It's useful for us.
Yes.
You're still falling a little bit into the rhythm in the music.
Yes.
And if we keep the verse pattern, then we'll find out why Messiaen wanted some bits long and not others. Great. Can we start again? Do you mind if I stop you every now and then? I'll put my hand up. Okay. What do you feel that pattern is about? By the way, I don't know the answer. If I ask you a question and I know the answer, that's an illegal move. So I ask you.
Yeah, shimmering, you know, because Messiaen is all about colors. I mean, his music is kind of like a kaleidoscope. You see colors and colors and shapes and shapes and that sort
sure.
of.
Sure. And maybe here it's the arms forming a circle each time, isn't it? Even if you look at it graphically. There is something all encapsulated with that feeling that you go exactly back to where you started a lot of the time.
Yes.
Super. So I want to know whether it's possible, the two of you, as you start it, that you can have the idea and join the round, as it were, not start the song, but just join in with the idea. So the idea is sub, and then it just comes out as you start singing. Does that make sense?
A ribbon that I'm weaving into the tapestry that she is already established.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes I feel like the voice is just sticking out too much.
Okay, I didn't get that, but I know what you mean. It would be nice if it was dovetailed. And I think, in a way, what you're doing, just a tiny bit in the shape there, her shape and your shape are a mirror image, aren't they? So if you support her, dee da dee da ba dee, take the dip and reflect her and see how that feels. Great. Now I'm going to be a complete pain and very pedantic for about a page. Is that okay? Good. First of all, I would say again.
We've never coached this.
Okay.
You're excited.
Fantastic. Okay. First of all, I feel you need to sing it. Don't feel you can't sing it. It doesn't mean you, in order to try and dovetail, the piano's got real brightness to its sound up there. You can. You don't have to play down, I would say, sing. But also, I think I need, first of all, a bit more of the sense of printemps enchaîné. It's still a little bit printemps enchaîné. So love up the, if you could love up the upbeat, that would be great. Printemps enchaîné. I think that would be great. And also, is it good news or bad news, Melissa? Yes. So it needs to look like good news. I'm just saying. Okay, it's a very beautiful thing you're giving the wife, you know, so it's good. Let's try. Beautiful, so much better, so much more present, and it looks great. I promise you don't look ridiculous smiling, it's just lovely. Can I have, just for your vowels, printemps en, the same vowel, printemps enchaîné, just that the en is not quite right there. Just check that. Then if you can, he's got that incredibly long trail away of enchaîné. See if you can do that and then disappear underneath her textures.
Okay.
Let's try that. Let's stop there. Beautiful. It's getting better and better. I don't know this piece super well, but my impression as a listener is that I need the outburst of, mon collier, more, what's the word, rhapsodic, if that makes sense. So we've got this quite sleepy, maybe even that the piano's gesture is just the sleeping body. You know how the back rises and falls with sleeping or something, or the side. Maybe that's all, but then you all of a sudden abandon that little leitmotif with this incredible rhapsodic, more collier. I think it should be a difference. So, more than you're doing. Tell me. Tell me why. I'll accept it if you have a very good reason.
I honestly, this is not a good reason why. My body just instinctually wants to do that every time that I sing this passage, because I sing it again, I sing it several times.
Okay.
And I can try it a different way. I don't really have a good reason.
No, I totally accept that. It's really a good enough reason. Can I share with you something? I'm just going to show you the screen. I showed the guys yesterday. There, back in the early 1900s, I think, there was a pedagogue who taught a lot of bel canto, and he made graphs of the bel canto shape. So if I show that to you, you can see that everything is a bit like, you know, pictorially what you do. And if you look at this one here, I think that's what you want to do. So in other words, you don't want to biff it, you want to bloom it. I agree with that, but I think the bloom has to happen more quickly to sound euphoric or rhapsodic, that's all.
Okay.
More, a kind of more open-hearted, generous, if that makes sense. Also, because remember, on the piano, we cannot do that, it's impossible. So you can soften the piano's doubling up with you by doing a bloom, but then support that. As the piano dies, you come up, so you have the impression together of something. See what I mean?
Crescendoing in enough time before her day crescendo?
On collier?
Yes, ma'am.
I don't think you have to worry about that because you're descending.
Okay.
He only asks you to say forte and then come down. And I think then, from my opinion, the piano should emerge through your B natural pitch to make the echo. She's simply echoing your slowdown. Isn't that right? So, and also it's really hard on the piano, but if you can have the sense with this final, that one, that you're just, in fact, it's not written down, you're just doing some form of rallentando, which is very organic. So we just find the arc, because I think, again, everything is circular in all this. Enchaîné is circular, the rainbow is half circle, the arms, there's a lot of that going on. So then... And then echo her to. That's just a natural rallentando written out, I think, if that makes sense. So you're one gesture together. Do you want to try that? Can we go maybe from Arc-en-Ciel? That would be great. Okay, I have a quick question. I'm sorry, I'm being such a pain, but I did warn you I was going to be a pain. You at the moment, you're being fantastic. Thank you both for being excellent rhythmically. I don't care about it anymore. Léger du matin. So that's that sleepy half thing of just dragging some of your words and then moving through. I think that's what he wants. So it's like a very free feel. I can just hear counting. So can we just have léger trails? Léger... du matin. Let's try it again. Beautiful. And then if you can, with the piano, that you really make the diminuendo, completely matches, it's difficult. But after that chord, let's come up with it there. Let the sound die and then tuck in the next chord at the level you've left that one. It's a kind of a cheat, but it's a nice cheat. We can try. there's one other thing I wanted to ask you about. I would love a bit more on the R. Mon collier. It's like you've found the best description of her. As you said, exactly as you described it. And you savor it a little bit more the second time. Just there would be great. I like very much that forte. How does it feel? Do you feel too brash or is it okay? Because?
Well, you know, you're a big voice, you're used to singing with orchestra, and you like all of that backup, and you feel like you can just sort of let it rip, and you're so exposed.
Yes.
To the piano. So that's a confidence issue on my part that, you know, is just a work in progress.
Okay. I must say what you'll get with piano is, and especially with a song, is within a very short space of time, incredible use of color and nuance, which I think informs all the stuff that you will do with orchestra anyway. It's like a perfect little study. And we accept that pianos, I'm a pianist, we're flawed because our sound decays as soon as we've played. But we get used to that, so our ears hear that it goes through. So I would say carry the piano noise to you with that and keep it sustained so that you'll also feed the piano sound with yours. It'll be a better match. Don't try and play within the piano. Be yourself. Okay, if that makes sense. Can I hear one more time? It'll go on. Beautiful. On you go. So just there, he does that little lovely little decoration. So he varies from vivant to lasse just a tiny bit. So I need to know that that's actually Melissa making it up, if that's okay. Melissa, in fact, the both of you making it up would be really useful, so that it's a little trail rather than something that's written down. Could be a little bit more like that. Petit. Also, make sure vivant has got the whole length. You were just quite short on vivant. You'll have time to breathe. And that means that then the piano can tuck into the end of your vivant. Again, so you can keep tucking into each other, if that makes sense. Can we try that again? Petit soutien. Okay, I would dare, do you want to dare just to connect with the piano entry, the next chord, so that you overlap just a tiny bit? Give that a go and see if it feels good. Great. So here I need that you have the step up from mezzo forte to forte. What would be the reason for doing that?
I think that, I mean, he's saying, he's using words like renewal and grace, and I think he's heard, he's noticing, and now he's actually feeling those sort of spiritual emotions starting to churn.
Super. So could it then be that the forte is just more fervent than the previous phrase?
Yes.
Okay, definitely. Great. I think that allows you then to have the melisma en grâce. But then whatever reason to do them, have the thought and then the dynamics will follow. Okay, let's go again from Petit Soutien. Soutien, sorry. I've got a question which you must say no to. Sorry, you're very welcome to say no to this, Melissa. Is there any way we can organize it that you don't breathe during grâce? How would that, is that possible either to breathe before de or after de? Shall we try? Let's try from for the moment, take a small breath for de sourire et. And then take the time to take a breath. Let's just see. Or you can make it work emotionally if you go de sourire de, but there's not much time to breathe before grâce. So see if you can do it before de. Let's just see. Amazing. It just bothered me before that you spit a word. That's all. I was being pedantic. And I think you can find a reason for that breath, which is an emotional reason, not a singer's need. Because obviously, Messiaen prizes most of the word grâce, that he puts so much into it. I would say you're even allowed, if you wanted to, move it forward a little bit. Because it's just a little melisma. That's all it is. Let's try it one more time. Can we go from Collier de Renouveau? So here, sorry to interrupt, he especially wants the breaths in the middle of the word kokas. I don't know whether that's because you are laughing at her, because she's funny. Whatever it is, I think it's joyful. So let's make sense of the breaths as you marvel at how funny she is or something. Beautiful. Any questions so far? How's it feeling? I didn't even talk about the sound. It sounds great. I'm just picking holes now because that's what I'm asked to do.
Ladies, I'm going to give about a 5-minute warning.
Thank you very much. Okay. So let's go again from, I love the build up from Collier d'Orient. That was great because now it gets more and more excited and then you laugh, I think. Presumably that's what that's about. Let's try it from there, if we may. Beautiful. So it seems to me that that laugh goes from pure laughing to something more loving by the end. Is that true?
Yes.
More fond. So I just need to hear a tiny bit more smile in your sound by the time the rallentando comes. What do you think?
Okay.
That is kind of, it sounds to me as if you are charmed at that point by it all. So it's really warm and really low. Tell me. Why not? I mean, there's a hell of a lot that's within the one thing which slowly expands and expands from that very simple piano introduction.
I think you really touched upon something there, though, for us to explore that we hadn't really thought of.
Why don't you give it a go again from Collier d'Orion, and I will leave you be till the end. Okay.
You know, we should definitely observe those, but also this idea of being really precise with the rhythm, where he's added that augmentation dot, right? Because it's such minimal variation.
Yes.
In terms of being really specific with that.
You mean to take breaths in between, or I didn't quite understand.
In the bottom of the page, I don't want to take time.
No, take time. We have time. Please, I'm interested.
The bottom staff.
Yeah.
After the first measure at the end, in my score, there's a little breath mark. But the last note is 3/16. So if we're being accurate and break those, it sort of plays into the playfulness of it, and we could mess around with that well.
But absolutely. Well, I would say what he's given you by putting the little apostrophe is you do exactly the rhythms, then you have time to breathe, and then you do the next thing.
Yeah.
So there's like a little hiatus of any of a size of your choice, which I think is maybe connected with the playfulness of it,
okay.
as you marvel at her. Yes. And I really admire how you've both clearly taken time to do that before. I think that is really important. And then once you've got that really in good shape, you can then add the other things. I think you're absolutely right. Yeah. Okay. The only thing, I love what you're doing, Melissa. The only thing is at the end, you've got a diminuendo. Just there. There's that last bar of that page. That's all the way through to the runtime. You slightly brought it up again as you went up. But see if you can tuck. And also that's the piano job as well, I think.
Okay.
As you know that moment when we stop laughing, something trails away. Isn't that right? I think this is a trail away of some sort. Please do argue if you want to think something else.
Thank you.
Beautiful. Well done, well done, well done. Just, I'm nearly there. Fantastic, Melissa. Just watch your tuning. Just there, just dropped a tiny bit there. Really beautiful. And then, sonata, then I would say for the piano, come up, drown her with the crescendo. Why not? I mean, it's what's asked. You incredibly tiny, and then you just take over and as you both go back to sleep or something. Beautiful, and then it all again trails away. Fantastic song. Thank you so much, Melissa. It's beautiful. And thank you both. Great job. So nice. I could spend all day doing that sort of stuff. Thank you.
That's so stunning. Thank you so much. Beautiful. Wonderful for singing and playing. Thank you both very much. Our next singer today is Gronja. If you could unmute yourself, let us know where you're calling from and what you will be singing.
Hi, Caroline. I'm calling from Berlin. And I'm going to be singing Striga la Vampa.
Great. Thank you. Can I quickly say to everyone, someone asked on the chat if I could send that page of the bel canto shapes. I'm going to WhatsApp it to Julie, and then Julie, you can do something clever to get it back on the thing. I didn't know how to do that, but I will do that. Super. Let me just find your Striga la Vampa. Somewhere here. Thank you. Thank you very much, and a big admiration for you keeping with your backing track, which is a robot. Brilliant. I get to it. Great. Okay. Can you first for me speak it like an actor? I just want to get the sense of, because this is quite beat bound. This holds us by the bar, and I want to see if we can leap over the bars to find which are the words we need, basically. So if you can just speak like an actor, the text.
Stride la vampa, la folle indomita, corre a quel fuoco.
Well done.
Yeah, sorry, just 2 seconds. I have the text here.
So. No problem.
Yeah. Okay.
Stride la vampa, la folla indomita, corri al quel fuoco, lette in sembianza, urli di gioia, intorno a Chegeno, cinta di scheri, donna s'avanza. Sinistra splende sui volti orribile, la tetra fiamma che salsa al ciel, che salsa al ciel.
Great, super job, you're doing so well. Che salsa al ciel, again, don't drop your lines ever. So if you were to, can you just say, is it Grenet? Tell me how I say your name.
Sorry, it's Gráinne. Let me just rename myself and that'll be easier. It's an Irish name, so it's not immediately obvious unless.
Okay, thank you very much. I don't want to mess it up every time.
No, you're grand. No worries. Okay.
Gráinne, fantastic. Thank you, Gráinne. If you were to say the words, I was speaking about this yesterday, you know Tarzan? Tarzan says, me Tarzan, you Jane, and that's all the information in 4 words.
Yeah.
We in life, we are Tarzans, but we add other things around and about it. So if you can find what your essential Tarzan words are, for example, in the first page, what would they be for you? If you pick the words that are the ones that are essential.
Okay.
Again, there's no right, one right way. It's just interesting to know what you would choose. I would say, I mean, my personal name, please argue with me. I would say stride.
Yeah, I was thinking about that. And the other one, it's orribili.
Super. You can actually, you've been so good, you can actually have more than that. I'm going to allow you more than that. I would say indomita.
Yeah.
Lieta, because that's interesting that they're happy. Lieta.
Yeah, and gioia was another one I was going to go
for. Yeah, nice.
It's quite horrible, isn't it? The juxtaposition of gioia with orribili and the act of this woman being burnt. You know?
Absolutely right. And so the as you describe it, those are the interesting bits that we're going to get. And what I like very much is instead of going urli di gioia, we go urli di gioia. So okay. That means we also don't drop the line as a descent. It's all useful for our purpose.
Okay.
Intorno e che, you know? And then on cinta di sgherri. Donna Savanza. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Where? What would you choose there?
After that, Caroline.
Yes.
Yeah. Sinistra and or no, see, actually, splende, orribile, fiamma, al ciel.
Okay. Super. So, just for fun, do it again. And every time you get a Tarzan word that you've chosen. Use your little painty finger to stroke it. That's all.
Okay.
You do exactly the same thing, but you just stroke those words as it goes through. Thank you. What does that feel like? You're allowed to say bad news or good news. I don't mind.
No, it's good news because it gives me the opportunity to colour those in a very specific way. I mean, obviously it's an exercise, but I think it's definitely an exercise to play with. So.
It means for me, I get a more elastic line from you as you have an outburst of something you need to say. Super. Now, permission to nag a bit. Can I be a nag? Okay. For example, when you have the B natural stri de la va, that looks like four Bs, but in real life it's one.
Okay.
And it's so that your breath never counts. Your breath only knows how to go V.
Yeah.
And the text underneath it will do the rhythm for us.
Okay.
So I'd also like to track your sustaining consonants like R and L and V and M. If we can keep those really on pitch and use them like fake vowels, it would be super useful for us. So if I would do this horrible exercise, could you only sing me the line, but on the sung consonants? So it would go like this. Something like that.
Okay. Yeah.
Just do that and do it a cappella is fine for me.
Is la a sung consonant?
It is, because you can sustain it. So give it a go. I just want to watch you. You're doing a great job. Good. So, and what we're going to practice is that all of those consonants are going to end up really buzzing here and not be at the back at all. The L, be careful that it doesn't lock at the back. So exactly where R is, you just plug it with L in the front and the tongue is soft at the back. And V, great. V is leaky air here and nothing at the back. V. Good. And again, I'm going to keep on nagging. The M is like, you know, you say, delicious. Super soft. So it's a very gentle Ziploc seal here and nothing elsewhere. V. Try one more time. Wonderful. And you should start feeling that the resonance stays in the same place.
Yeah.
Let's go again from the beginning. Fantastic. Put that in and just see if it made a difference. So slightly lengthen those vowels just for the exercise. Brilliant. Does it feel different to you?
Yeah.
I hear the stretch of one pitch now, which is great.
Yeah.
Super.
Yeah.
And then let's go on. There was the other thing I want to ask. Good. If you can keep absolutely strict, you are doing it, but you can be even better. Ti-da-dum, ba-dum, bum-ba-dum, ba-dum, every single time. Because
okay.
That is the decoration of Azucena to the line. The line should be... The rest is your gypsy soul having a rhythm.
Oh, I love that. Thank you.
So it's like a ba-dum ba-bum or something like that. Okay, that's a decoration made by Grania stroke Azucena.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's try that. Oh, yeah, nice. Let's do that. We'll do the skeleton first. So in tempo, I'm going to play. I'll just keep playing so I don't lag. And you're just going to give me the skeleton without those decorations. Here we go. Great. Now do it again, and you're like your most musical version of that, like it's exactly what was written. Okay, here we go. Wonderful. Now, Grania decides, as a chain, you want to add a little bit of spice to it.
Okay.
Here we go. I'll play. It's really good. It could be even cleaner. I'm getting a smear.
No, Is it not that?
Yeah, with a trill, but then the trill exists and then the rhythm exists. So this has to be one time. Try it again. Great, so that if you can even practice isolation, so it really has that sense of the dance. Again. Good, better, much better. On you go. Good, and now with that legato at the same time. So you, so a bit like those shapes I showed you. Let me show them to you again, because if you think like this, it could be helpful. So you get a little sense of pearls of those little accents.
Okay.
Ba-da-dum-ba-dum. In fact, I'm going to let me find, for example, this one down here. Bum okay. Ba-dum ba-dum. You never lose the line, but you've got those little pearls on it.
Okay.
One more time, I'll play.
The dance thing was interesting. I mean, I don't know whether you could see, but I was doing a little bit of a dance.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Because it also, it allows you to embody it and free it. All of that. Absolutely. Great job. Let's go on. Cor. Super job. Now you can add one detail. The car, even though it should be a soft ending to a word, has got a little accent on it.
Okay.
So again, think of one of those pictures. One second, I'll just bring this up. Here, this one I spoke about earlier, where you come in, you bloom it, as I was saying to Melissa.
Yes, okay.
So, car, so that you never biff him. That's what I like about those graphs. Nothing's biffed.
Yeah.
You come in and bloom.
Okay, yeah.
So, let's get from corre. Good. On you go. Okay, I'm going to nag you like hell. Very nice. Those have to be in the dance, not just smooshed. Yeah. Enjoy that. Dance away. It's marvelous. Urli. Fantastic. Now, do the same thing, but like an elastic t-shirt. Da ba dum ba dum, really connected. It's good. The second one's not in rhythm. Dim ba bum ba ba. You're slightly falling into it. Yes.
After, yeah.
Exactly. So just for the horrible exercise, I don't mind if you go or, but I want you to do that line with that. So I want to hear the definition. That's really good. That's really clean. And everything gets love, all the little notes as well. One more time like that, and then we'll do it properly. Normal. Yes, it's not quite the same when you do that dim, dim, ba-dum, ba-da. You're shortening the dotted 16th a little bit. The brrr version is excellent.
Okay. I hear it, yeah.
Well, now legato. Bam, ba-dum, ba-dum. Bum ba-dum ba-dum, like a dance. Good. Now here, I'm interested in, I like very much when you mix it down there. I'm interested in your G. Are you going? Are you mixing it? Are you staying up? What are you doing?
I'm not sure.
Let's play.
I think I'm trying to stay it up, keep it up.
I like that idea. Can you just do this for me? So let's go. NG. So that one means at the moment you're, I think something here, keep your thread really loose and just think of that, the sigh of that. So, just quickly, can we do this exercise? Just give me, good. Now slow it up a little bit because we're going to start just exploring. So do that one again. It's fantastic. So do that one. And then just really just slide back and forth. Good. Fantastic. So basically, Grania, you're playing trombone and not piano at this point. Keep going. Can play. I would say that your voice will mix as it goes, so yeah. Leave it be and see what happens. This is again just exploring. Yeah. One more. Good. So that area around there is always the most interesting one to me of people, what they're going to do in terms of, I suppose, gathering the sound and making it, matching it up.
Yes, yeah, yeah.
And
yeah.
That exercise will just allow your throat to understand what's happening a little bit. Yes, so it's doing it nice and slowly. So, one more time, slow this one. Good. So now. Great. So practice this. Practice that a little bit just to find out which, how you want to thread the sound.
Yeah.
Okay. Sinistra. So in fact, do those pictures I showed you. Yeah. Pull the sound. But it's really all t-shirt material.
Yeah.
Try sinistra. That is so much better, I can't tell you. Certainly from my online reception of it. What do you think you're doing when you do that?
I think I'm taking it away from what I'm doing here into what I'm doing here.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Fantastic. So if this is free, basically this is loose, this is a resonating space.
Yeah.
And your body will do what you need. It should work, I think,
strictly
speaking. Let's just try that again. It was great. So do you just pull the sound? Go on. Fantastic. I like that very much. You cut the t-shirt material on tra.
Yes.
Instead of, just think of flexing the same piece of da, and then a little bit more da. That's the decoration. Again, you should be singing or something like that.
Yeah.
The rest is your gypsy soul.
Yeah. Even that fourth up.
That's a stretch. Wonderful. So you need to not come, your M's, you brought the M in too early, I think.
Yeah.
And I would say use one M on there and one M on there, and you will glue together that really well.
Okay.
Last minute, fiamma, and you go through the pitches on the M. Try that. Fantastic. Now a little bit more pop of energy on the double of M.
Okay. Yeah.
And it's useful in any case. You should feel more comfortable. Remember the M is here, nothing at the back. Okay, I like that. I think you could do better. I don't think that's high in any way for you.
Yeah.
So I need you to love up to those notes.
Yeah. Okay.
Can you do for me? Good. So you have energy all the way through because I gave you a nice high note to start on. So make sure you love all the other notes. As if you were singing them all high. Okay. Fantastic. Now I would say you need less air pressure up there.
Okay.
Because at the moment you're almost going sharp now. It's really good, but I don't think you need that much. So can you first brrr it for me? So you're increasing air pressure and you simply don't need to.
Oh, okay. So I'm still increasing it with that. Okay.
Yeah, even that. I can add exactly. So keep the same air pressure. Rather use your yoga muscle to support, and if you need to stabilize anything, but I would keep the same aperture here and the same airflow. One more time. And then let it spin. Fantastic. With that air pressure, let's try and sing it. Fantastic. The very beginning of it, the S is gripping you rather than becoming another bit of air escaping. Okay, keep the S right at the tip, and there's not a gripped, but rather like a leaky bicycle tire. Let's see if that works.
Okay.
It's marvelous, but I still don't get the spin immediately on the R vowel, which makes me think something is being held.
Okay, yeah.
Tell me.
Yeah, I agree with you on that. And I think I've probably manufactured the spin with air pressure.
Okay.
So now I'm trying to think how
can sure. Can I watch you sideways? Can you go sideways? I want to see what's going on. Good. So what you need for me more is the sense that the sound is going up here and you don't have to tuck back too much. This can stay loose and dangly.
Okay.
And that the idea is that the soft palate will lift and it's that way.
Okay.
That's what I can say. Like a pre-sneeze, you know? You know, just before you sneeze.
Oh, yes. Yeah.
Just.
I heard priest's knees as in...
I'm gonna use that now and just watch people look confused. I love it.
sorry.
Exactly like a priest's knees, if you can do that.
Do you want me to turn sideways again? Or?
Yeah, do. I just want to see that, if you don't mind. Great. Does it feel any different to you? You're allowed to say no.
Better. It feels much easier. Yeah.
It should feel like there is less to do and it's a smaller place. It's gone further away.
Yeah.
Exactly. And while you're up there, you're just one of those dancers. You can just hover. That's all it needs. Okay.
Yeah.
Super. Let's go on.
Okay.
Okay, marvelous. Now it's so good. I'm going to keep nagging. Always a new goalpost nagging.
Yeah.
At the moment, you're three stops early, so it almost sounds like a double D on three there. Yeah. Three there. If the there is just that, I'm sure you know this, the flip of the tongue, and nothing. Yeah. So yeah. that the jaw is not the jaw is not used at all. Three there. So just plug with the tip of your tongue and the corner between the hard palate and the tooth. Okay. Whenever you're ready. Wonderful. You're kicking. Fantastic. Grania, you're slightly kicking on the, to be emphatic, the B. Keep the same B natural.
Okay.
Stretch it and do that thing that the Italians do, which is give emotion to the vowels,
yes,
not the consonants.
Sorry.
Don't worry. Super. Could you tell the difference when you did that?
Yes, I could. It was more connected, which felt great. Yeah.
Great. So that you basically it's just kind of spew.
Yeah.
It's just leaving you. There's nothing you can do about it except allow it to flow smoothly.
Yes.
Let's do it again. Super job. Good. Just now on the end, it's all great, but at there at that point, the N is slightly at the back, so it gets a slightly more hollow sound. Can you give me N? In fact, let's play our horrible consonant game. So in that phrase, it starts with N. Because you only can sustain an N, R, and V. Can you show me that? Okay, so that is a little bit still in here. Keep the throat really loose. If you were to say to me, Grania, if you were to say to me the word ha.
Ha.
Now, entirely silently. Really loose. That is open throat. So that's all you want for the throat. The tongue will do what it needs to. And is, when you breathe in, you're drinking in the air. So everything is really quiet here.
Yes, okay.
So if you give me N. It's okay, but it hasn't hit the spot. Can I have the back of your tongue in floppy E position? Good. One more time. Wonderful. So those are your machine here, for your factory here for leaking air. Now give me the actual phrase. Nero. Wonderful. Ska. Oh, there's something there which is a bit stiff in your throat, in your R vowel.
I think it's probably my tongue. Yeah.
Okay, thank you for coming clean. So let's say you're going to keep the tip of your tongue gently touching the back of your bottom teeth all the time. As soon as you flip to a consonant, it comes back down. Let's just see if you've diagnosed well. Can I go from nero? Great. Give me NG with the tip of the tongue down. Yes. That one.
Yeah.
I think, I mean, God knows me on online, so I don't know if I'm absolutely right, but that one sounds as like it's got more quality on it.
Yeah, it does here as well. Yeah, yeah.
So that means you're basically dangling it from the higher position rather than having to find a new setting in your throat.
Yes, yeah, yeah, yeah.
So can we imagine, where did we get to? Where did I find that? Where did I find that G? This is Scalzo. Very good. So can I have brilliant. And even the K, if you were to say,
oh, hello. Oh. Hi.
She's coming back. She's getting reconnected.
No worries. Sorry.
Carrie, if you are back, you're muted, so we need you to unmute yourself.
How very odd. Hello, I'm glad I'm back. Sorry, sorry, Ronya. Here we go. Let's do that again. And the K, if you can think of an irritating Hollywood star child saying, I want a cookie. Can you say, I want a cookie?
I want a cookie.
Cookie, cookie, cookie.
Cookie, cookie, cookie.
Ladies, I'm going to give you about a 5-minute warning.
Thank you very much. Cookie, cookie, cookie.
Cookie, cookie, cookie.
So you should feel that the K is way further forward in your mouth.
Yeah.
So that for your skelter, rather than being plosive at the back, I would keep it there.
Okay.
Ska, that is going to let your tongue be freer too as well. Can I try that? On you go. Great. Green. If you line it up this way, gri, so that this is dangling, but yeah, the tongue is in a floppy E position, so you have this real gri, E. Okay. I suggest to you that that gri was in a great position. I don't know if you can feel it. It went bam.
Yeah.
So I would put leko in the same, give me gri le, and the tongue changes very little and you should keep the same resonance. Go gri le.
I'll do it again.
So again, just like your grido, which is in such a good shape. So, dangle here. So again, to remind you, fiamma, join those two notes together with the M. And with your L, don't biff the L, let the L flip and then give something to the vowel. La, la. Thank you so much, Ronia. Great.
Caroline, thank you. That's brilliant.
Great. Mostly, I would say just enjoy that all your vowels stay in the same slot and you find that sweet spot. And you'll know it. It'll feel like your head's like a pair of dark glasses of resonance.
Yes. Thank you.
And otherwise, fantastic. I love your dancing. Thank you for your dancing.
Thank you.
See you then. Bye-bye. Thanks.
Ladies, thank you so much. Wonderful work. Lovely to hear you as always, Ronia. All right, our last singer for the day is Kimberly. Kimberly, if you could please unmute yourself, let us know where you're calling from and what you will be singing.
Yes, hi, I'm Kimberly. I will be singing Por Di Amor, and I am in Denver, Colorado.
Great. Por Di Amor, 1 second.
Oh,
Thanks, Kimberly. Thank you so much. Great job. Such a hard aria. Really well done. Tell me what the situation is here.
I know what's happening in the story, but I play with different scenarios of what she's actually feeling.
Okay. Can I ask you then, could we go through the text and you can tell me what you mean by stuff? So, for example, to whom do you speak?
In my mind, I'm...
No, in the text, to whom do you speak?
My husband?
No, it's to the God of love.
Oh.
Amor. I think that's one of the things, important things about this. It's looking for a solution from the God of love, whose help you need to fix something.
I see, yes.
Your tesoro is your husband.
Okay.
Isn't that right?
Yes.
So in fact, you've got a prayer, which is, it's useful then, because there's a prayer for someone who can be, you know, you can have the God of love in the room with you. It doesn't have to be so... It doesn't have to be talking about someone who's not there. You can actually have them in the room with you in your mind.
Okay.
Carrying on. When you say o mi rendi il mio tesoro, what does the o stand for?
Good question. So for me, I was just thinking of it as an o.
Okay. Just for you to know, it's an Italian construction, which is either or. So you're saying either give me back my love, my husband, or let me die. So the or there is not an outburst, it's just an either or. It's like a construction. So that also gives us something to play with, because to me, the Rosina that we've seen out of chronological time, of course, as Rosina, the witty one in Barbara Seville, she's still got the strength in her, and she's looking for a solution. She's not just mourning, if you like. She's already worked out that there are a couple of good options she's got, which either of which she will be, in a way, she'll process and make okay. See what I mean?
Yes.
Because my theory, and you're very welcome to, please do argue with me, is that we have to play positive in this in order for the audience to get the sense of loss. You're what, 2 years into marriage and it's all fallen about you, and you're trying to process and find a solution. What do you feel?
I actually like that, because I think that what I always was struggling with is kind of this sense of victimhood and this sense of I'm going to do something about it.
Right? Absolutely.
Trying to figure out where to sit there. How much is she angry? Because it's so many feelings. How much is she angry? How much is she hurt? How much is it about losing control? How much... It is just real raw vulnerability.
Mm-hmm. So I think in a way, because De Ponte is a genius, as is Mozart, if you simply represent the text well, the audience will be processing, everyone in the audience is going to be processing something similar, you could bet your boots. So the idea is to give the honest, plain version across, and they will find the message they need, rather than us over-interpreting a sense of loss or something. Do you know what I mean? That's my feeling. Let's start from the beginning. Could you speak it to me like an actor?
Sure. Porgi amor qualche ristoro al mio duolo, a miei sospiri.
Good, and even there, keep the connection. Qualche ristoro al mio duolo, ai miei sospiri.
Porgi amor qualche ristoro al mio duolo, a miei sospiri.
Great.
O mi rendi il mio tesoro, o mi lascia almen morir. O mi lascia almen morir.
So what's the point of only repeating that one, that bit of the phrase? Open question.
Or else let me... I think it's... It has to be two different feelings. I think the emphasis of the first one is like, or else, it's almost like she finds, or else let me die, kind of in that moment. And then or else this is death for me. This is death in a million ways.
Okay, good. So the jeopardy is either I get him back or I have no reason to live anymore. That is the interesting jeopardy which you're feeling. So as you say it, you understand the truth of it, presumably.
Yes.
Because maybe this is the first time you've put those words out into the world, let's just say, for the sake of the opera. Because in act two starts, we have known nothing about you. We really don't know what's going on until you say that. And it's a bomb. A bomb has gone off, which is going to cause a change for the rest of the opera. It's really interesting. Such a two-page aria can do all of that. Very good. Going back, thank you for that. Going back, what I was doing earlier as well, I'd like to look at the harmonic skeleton and find out which bit is Kimberly decorating and which bit is Mozart's skeleton, if that makes sense. So, for example, Borgia, qualche ristoro al mio duolo ai miei sospiri. In fact, it's all B flat, isn't it? Everything else, you've decided to pull and express, if I can say that. So could you just sing it for me all on a B flat and see if you can make it make sense? Fantastic. Okay, so that is let's say the underlying skeleton. Now let's see if Kimberly can decide it's dull like that, so you want to decorate a little bit. And it happens to be the right notes. Okay. But it's really you. Okay, I'm going to play you in if I may. Fantastic, already better. Because now I understand is a little decoration which you had to pull up. Like I was saying to Gronia, like a t-shirt, that was a little stretch of the same note. It also meant you didn't give me a downbeat. And in this classical period, downbeats are just slightly vulgar. We try not to do them. Upbeats are the way forward. Beautiful. Can we do it again? I'll play you in. Fantastic, fantastic. So, and then the last minute thought, such a beautiful little turnaround. Can I offer you the challenge? In fact, do you know the notes without looking at music? Can we do a bit by bit? Do you have in that room anywhere some kind of scarf or long piece of material that we can use? Oh, great. Perfect. Ah, that's perfect. So for the moment, I want you to think of it as a scarf. As you draw, that is your breath doing the phrase, very smooth, that you don't stop and go, qualche ristoro. It's all just one air flow all the way down. And also, it's as if you're singing one note, but it happens to be that different notes are coming out because of how you're feeling. So you're not doing shelves. You've got a slope going on. Let's just hear that. So it's not a stretch at the moment. It's a gentle hand drawing through. Beautiful. Fantastic. What does that feel like?
Yeah, the line's less interrupted.
Great.
It's more... Right, it's across the bar lines. There's not. Here's
Wonderful. So then we get these short phrase, long phrase, which is typical Mozart as well. Can I have one, ask for one more thing? As you do that final little turn, can you, let's just think, can you lament or complain that? Because I want to get that sound in your, that slightly tilted sound. And then just complain. In England, we say whinge. Do you have whinge?
I know what whinge means.
Okay. I want you to whinge that last little bit. That's okay. Beautiful. Keep the faithful to the rhythm. Don't schlep too much. Right, while you go on. So again, here the skeleton. Let's hear that, because that's basically a long sigh all the way down from the top, isn't it?
Yes.
Leave our variations alone.
Sorry?
So, good. So now, the rest is... this is a little twist of pain. So really finesse it like one little thought. Good. That's really beautiful. I would say the word is duolo. If you like, you can cheat a tiny bit so that you slightly rubato. So the bass, the principal note gets a little bit more love before you move off it. Great. Can you feel that? It means you get the sense of the word when you, and it's not too mechanical. Go on. I'm Yesor.
I'm Yesor.
Okay, that's fine, but you can't have as much time taken on in Mozart as that. Even if you see the coupling of the articulation. Beautiful. I have a question for you here. The placement of the R. Can we do an experiment? Can you, instead of taking a throat breath, can you do a smelling a rose deeply breath? And then the in your mouth is ah, in your lip is oh. So you're not pulling the tongue back for oh. Just try that, I'm interested. Emily, that's really beautiful. Let's do it again. And can you make, just for the sake of science, because I'm interested for experiment, these things I was talking about, can you find a little shape? Oh, so let it bloom. In a way, it doesn't really matter what shape, as long as the vowel is always living.
Okay.
Breathe through your nose. Well done. And also your breath kept going well done. To me, that was a better placement for the whole phrase. I don't know if you felt that.
Yeah, it felt much better.
What's the difference? What does it feel? What's the difference?
Part of it is when I was thinking about the shape, I was thinking about it moving in a circular motion and forward.
Mm-hmm.
So I think what that allowed is for the sound to stay in the front, have that ping in the front, but for the space to open up more and more in the back. So
great.
Stuck back there.
Super.
Stuck up here.
And sometimes if you have time, if you breathe the smelling the rose breath, it allows, if you think about it, and also the old Italians talk about drinking the air in, it allows your tongue to be soft and slightly raised. So that means when the air comes across it, it's not dropping back to give you that other thing we're talking about.
I find it also reminds me to breathe low. It just kind of necessarily starts lower in my abdomen, that breath.
Yes, which is a lovely side product of all of that. That's good. And it's nice and calm. I'm going to bring you in now with the introduction just before that. And I'd love you to do that breath and see what the time is that you need for it. Okay. So you've just done miei sos. Great job. So I love all that. I think your entrances are much smoother now too. Great. That's a horrible phrase, isn't it? I'm wondering what happens if we were to reverse you. What would that be like? Breathe through your nose, find that little place, tiny little place, and come down. Super, great job. Now I want to get the consonants on your lip rather than further back. So let's say the exercise we were doing before, all the consonants that you can sustain sound on, M, L, L, M, M, R. Isn't that right? So could you only sing for me also? We have to start with M because we're not doing the vowels. Keeping them all here soft. Fantastic. You do that incredibly easily. Can we do that again? So everything is all really here for the consonants. One more time. Super. Now give me the phrase, still coming from the top, and thread those consonants through the vowels like that. Really on the lip. Already much better. We just need a little bit more consonants sometimes out of you. I think you're making a slightly big shape in your mouth. I'm interested in that. So is the tip of your tongue coming down the front when you finished with the consonants? Yeah.
Sometimes it's pulled a little bit back.
Okay. Let's just see. You know the NG. So you know, do you know about mironing?
Yes.
Can you mirin that for me? Good. But you can actually do those consonants. So you just keep on freeing the front of the tongue. Super. Now, with mironing, but keeping that, having that idea that you're starting already in that position. Great, much better. How's it feel?
Good.
Tell me.
Still, I think that I've gone kind of a pendulum swing with my consonants. It was kind of too much muscling going on at first, and then now I'm kind of maybe not getting them as much. The NG with the consonants was hugely helpful to feel where they're hitting in my mouth, so that really helped a lot.
Super.
I think I could probably do it a few more times to really...
Can I offer you one more exercise? Ideally, you'd have a cork, Or you can have your, I mean, you might want to wash your thumb, but I want you to put your thumb very gently here. Do you want to wash it first?
No, okay.
So very gently here, like a retriever dog holding a dead duck and not wanting to hurt any feathers. Very gentle, okay. And then relax your jaw and your lips around it. Now, if you speak, oh, mi lachal men mori, you should feel the tip of the tongue striping the cork as you say the L's and N's and so on. Try that.
Oh, mi lachal men mori.
Well done, well done. And the as soon as the tongue is striped, it goes to the front, not pulling back. Oh, mi lachal men mori, and resting just there. Try. Good. Now, try singing like that with a cork in. Good. And as you go up, remember to whinge a little more. I would whinge in a way from the F onwards up there. One more time with cork in. Good. Now, let go. Try it now and just remember that that's what your tongue had to do against the cork. Let's see if it's made a difference. That's how free and active the and independent the front of the tongue is. Let's go from Omi Lashal Memory, the first one. So, I'll play you into that. So you need to practice that so you can keep the independence there. I want to ask you to do one more thing for me. I need to be sure as you're going up that you are free in your hips. Could we do some bad dad dancing? You know what I mean by that? Bad dad. So fathers in England can't dance. So they do this kind of chaotic thing here with no with no true form. So it can't be good. It's got to be bad. So can you just do that for me? I just want to see what's going on there. And also, let's go, you can really let that M, the lips meet, they can meet. Bit of bad dad, I'm going to give you one bar in. Job. So what happens?
I felt like I could access more of my support, and also just the whole tract, like the whole thing was just a little more loose.
Super. So you're more of a tube. All that happens when you do bad dad, it means you can't grip these ones, which seem to me like our safety valve for, if I just do that, it'll work. But if you keep those loose, then the airflow can happen really well. So great job. Practice bad dad and then slowly bringing bad dad into stillness. Mm-hmm. And you should feel that at any moment you could break into bad dad, but you won't, obviously. Yes, because that's never going to work. Lovely job. Let's go on. Porgia amor.
Porgia amor col Cristo.
Good. So can we be aware that... is the scant. That's just a little decoration. It's like a very slow trill, isn't it? Okay, so that's really good, but you did a bit of a on that one. And if you were to do a little whiny kitten, so a little bit more tilt and a little bit of bad dad, I think it would be a different sound. Can we try? Just experiment. So when you take the breath, Ame Sospir, you take a breath, don't you? Before Omi, quite right. And then make sure, see if you can take it through your nose just for now and feel that gentle drinking in of the air. Very nice. Porgi amor. really that was fantastic. It seemed so smooth and so easy and so much like the tube you were talking about, the tract. You went totally still, and then you did a little bit of that instead. Trust to the bad dad just for a little bit so you see that actually staying fluid is better for you. So super good. One thing I would ask again, just as a fun, for the onset, for like that last onset, Omi Lasha, think of gliding onto it rather than trying to guarantee it.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So let's go from Omi, take a breath, and then just glide. Fabulous. What's the difference for you when you do that?
It feels less like I'm fighting with myself. It feels like everything is flowing the way that it should, and I'm not, there's not that kind of stuck energy. Does that make sense?
Absolutely. So you're not having to guarantee something will work. It's like, I've just been in 3 weeks away at something, and one of the people who was teaching a lot was this Barbara Frittoli, who's amazing, and she spent all her time. As soon as someone sang something, she would say no, and she would try and get the onset good. Because once the onset is, once you remove the wanting from the onset, you'll be able to glide, and it's just a much easier job. and then in a way, you can just say what you feel, because you're not having to guarantee or want something.
Yeah.
It's a bit hippie to describe it like that, but I think it is an important thing.
Yeah.
And that the wanting gets in our way a little bit with these things. And you naturally have those beautiful sounds, so I would see if you can risk the glide. But just before we stop, I'm not quite sure how much time we've got left, but could we do that after the high... Say again?
You've got a full 10 minutes at least.
Oh, fantastic. Okay, so we have time. Kimberly, then if we could just go... In fact, let's go from the beginning and let's concentrate on the onsets, if that's okay.
Yes.
And Is it easier if I play for you, or would you rather use your backing track? I don't mind.
I was just going to ask you the same. I don't have a preference.
In a way, because I'm going to stop to allow you to take time for the onset, I'll play. Otherwise, you might be trying to keep going. So I will always give you room. And in particular, when you start an onset on a vowel, just really think about that, the gentle glide on. Better.
It felt a lot better. The last phrase, I kind of lost myself a little bit, but the phrases leading up to that.
So there's a calmness about knowing that once you've glided in, you can just carry on. Fantastic. I'd like to go from Almio. Could we treat that whole bar as an upbeat bar into Duolo? So you're not going to land until Duolo. Good and fantastic. Now just bend that tiadidum a little bit.
Oh.
Really well done. A soup until then. Your oars are so much better.
Thank you. So processing all the things, what I really noticed there at the end with that last phrase is I got really tight through my hips. So thinking about keeping the consonants forward and preparing the onset, something happened where I got really, so I needed some.
Perfect. Perfect. That's what we're looking for. So you just start recognizing things. Let's do it now with some bad dad. I don't know if this, I don't know if that makes sense to you, but excuse me. If you have as your median level the F of R, can you think that everything dangles from there and then picks up again? So you're basically only singing with this kind of sort of dangly bit there. That makes sense. I loved your onset. Honestly, it's so much purer. Bad dad, I'm going to give you after tesoro. Tesoro. Better. Now, when you're on it, you need to have an image. There's a fantastic Korean tenor I know who says when he sings his top notes, he imagines painting a very small part of the wall back and forth the same color. Yeah. So he's doing something incredibly small but very repetitive. So you have to keep the life in it. So if you can keep think of something that allows you just to keep painting that. Yeah. Do you want to try that? Otherwise, really good. How did it feel?
Much, much easier, much freer. And thinking about dangling down from the top, those last couple notes were just so easy to access.
Wonderful. So let's do that one more time, if you don't mind. Tesoro. Just 1 minute. Kimberly, I think that one was not as glided onto. Breathe through your nose and just have that sense of air in, air out. So
I forgot a little bit about your direction for the last note there. I was thinking about all the things leading up to it.
But the approach is much better. Then all you need to practice is that idea or these that you give yourself life to that last. So you can even think about messe di voce, invisible messe di voce, anything that allows the body to say, I'm not in fight or flight, it's absolutely fine up here. Okay. Freakish though it is that you can sing like that. Have you got one more in you? Let's do it. So tesoro. Oh, I know what we'll do. You will just feed that A flat with your scarf or whatever that is.
Okay.
That's always going to happen. Tesoro. On you go. Good. Let's just look at that. Once you've done may as well be again, don't want, just glide. Lost kitten in a cave, and then tesoro, just flip the R without jaw. Yeah. Excellent. You can do even better. So breathe in and let it glide down the printed tray of your tongue like that. Good. Fantastic job. Now, just keep the tongue not pulling back. If you were to say to me with your tongue out, yeah, the third in time, so slow. So there is a gradual creep back in, that's what I'm flagging. So just keep it out for now so that your back of your tongue does not want to support for you. Brilliant. So now, breathe through your nose, smelling the rose deeply. Tongue sleeping. Great. Tell me, can you summarize for me?
Can I summarize kind of all the things?
Only the things that are useful, because not everything will be useful.
I think that the kind of breathing through the nose, that permission to do that in certain spots, that's really helpful. The kind of thinking about the onset a little bit more intentionally. That's really helpful. Keeping my hips loose has been that no one has ever mentioned before. That's brand new, and I'm excited about that. I think kind of it all sums up in just sort of like the keeping the tube feeling free and open.
Fabulous. And I think that should happen naturally, so it's nothing's difficult, because you've got all those notes, it's really beautiful, and you've got this fantastic shiny sound, especially when you were drinking in the air, and it was just kind of spewing. It was really beautiful. If you can think about playing, I guess it's less satisfying because you can't hurt it. It just has to leave you. But the more you think about that, it's really great.
It's more control and less control, if that makes sense.
Yes.
Some of these things I do are helping control, and I don't even realize that.
Yeah, and it's certainly a lot of concentration, especially because you're trying things for the first time. But it should feel easy because you have the voice. You know, it shouldn't be hard. Thank you very much, because you were incredibly good at trying lots of really hippie stuff. So thank you very much for your patience.
Thank you. I loved it. This is wonderful.
Really, really, really fantastic. And in fact, all of you, what is very rewarding. It's actually really nice having so much more time with each person, especially online, because then one can sort of try and mess about a bit. So really fantastic. Thank you.
All right. Thanks, everybody. Really wonderful work. Fantastic singing. It's been an absolute pleasure just to be a fly on the wall for the last 2 hours. Caroline, thank you so much again for being with us. We look forward to the next time. And everyone, thank you again. And we'll see you soon.
Fantastic. See you soon.
Caroline,
bye. Bye. Great job.